welcome along to the project.
Tonight on the show, is it time that all dental care was funded for New Zealanders? We talked to one dentist on the front lines, and we've got a look at the life of an SPCA officer, a 9-to-5 job that for many is really 24/7.
And we've got Patrick Gower here. Yeah. Check it out. Those dental pictures, do that bring back any memories for you?
Well, regular viewers of the show will know that I had the nickname Paddy Carrots when I was younger because of my elongated extra big front teeth. Now, they were actually smashed to smithereens in the late 1980s on the hydroslide known as the black hole in
nice
Rotorua.
Carrots.
Oh.
Yeah, carrot teeth versus hydroslide.
Oy.
And that meant actually thousands, hundreds of hours and thousands of dollars of dental work on these little babies.
Oh. You pay for it?
Man, you poor
wee thing. ACC, actually. Yeah. ACC.
Oh, well, right. You're lucky, is a strange word to use about that story, but lucky that it was an accident and so it was covered. But for many people, the care that they desperately need for their teeth is expensive and out of reach. So we're going to talk more about that soon. But first up tonight, we are beginning, this is exciting, our first themed week of 2019. This is where we take one topic, something that affects you all, and look at it from a whole lot of different angles, and this week we're talking about breaking up.
Yeah, breaking up. Why? It's a tough topic, but we reckon it's something we need to talk about. Breakups can be, believe me, the worst moments of your life, but they can also be quite a positive thing.
First up today, how do you know if a breakup is inevitable? We'll speak to a private investigator in a moment. She has seen firsthand the clues that it's all over. But first, overseas researchers say that they can tell almost immediately if a couple is doomed to fail. 'Cause breaking up is hard to
do. I don't mess with drama.
Counsellor, to get you help, you do it. That's when you can sort it out. No problem.
Taking responsibility, hey? Please thank Julia Hartley Moore.
To some basketball news now. This game in the States proved you should keep your head in the game no matter what happens.
Yeah.
Just awful. Now, everyone loves the cute animals, but for those animals considered a bit less cute, their last hope is often the amazing people of the SPCA. And today we're looking at a day in the life of an SPCA officer. A warning about this one, though, some viewers may find the images distressing.
Keeping our furry friends safe doesn't come cheap. Coming up, earlier it sounded like a major DHB was calling for free dental care for all New Zealanders. Now they're not, so what happened? And Phil Goff talks scooters, waterfront stadiums, that big boat race coming. Is Auckland ready? You're watching The Project.
Up next, get the gang together for another explosive Married at First Sight Australia. Then Nathan Fillion is put through his paces in The Rookie. And Kiefer Sutherland stars in the gripping Designated Survivor. It's all good on 3.
And next over on 3 Life, your fave chefs go on an Aussie weekend getaway for a fun foodie adventure in Boys Weekend. Whatever you love about life, there's something for you over on 3 Life. For you, Channel 11 and Sky Channel 29.
Oh, you're just getting a tarot card reader on board to see how many more kids I'm likely to have. That'll be good info. So I've got Neil here from the audience to tell you what is coming up. Neil, all yours, buddy.
Thanks, Jeremy. Coming up, millennials are spending 70% more time somewhere than the rest of the population. But where? Find out next.
Millennials.
Caught our eye, the rise of the homebody economy is upon us. Researchers have found millennials spend 70% more time at home than the rest of the population, while in the UK they're closing 18 pubs every week. In New Zealand, we're seeing steady increases in food delivery and home entertainment options.
Yeah, I'm rocking a bit of a homebody here, actually. So, seeing me.
This is serious for you and me, though, because when our daughters are teenagers and they get in trouble, we're going to say to them, hey, you're grounded, and they're going to say, sweet.
It's happening in Auckland because you just want to get your money's worth, right?
Right.
You've paid so much for the house.
You're public health specialist Jonathan Broadbent joins us now from Dunedin. Jonathan, how has the cost of dental care gone up relative to wages?
Well, the difference in the cost of an average-sized filling has gone from about $50 in the 1990s.
As it would be for the rest of New Zealand. I've got a view on it. Every form of income needs to be treated fairly. We shouldn't be taxing some forms of income and making other forms of income exempt. That's inherently unfair. Okay. That's why most countries in the world have a capital gains tax.
All right. Good luck. Please put your hands together for Phil Goff.
Thank you very much. Well
handled. Thank you. More to come on the project.
Projects.
Being an uncle or auntie is a special responsibility. It's important we take it seriously. So when you're asked to do a running race with your niece and nephew...
I promise I won't do that to any of my nieces. Tomorrow on the show, this could get awkward. Comedians Eli Mathewson and Brinley Stent used to be an item, but they went their separate ways. So we're putting them in different rooms to talk us through their breakup and see if their stories match up afterwards.
Oh, that'll be good. Hey, for now, though, please thank Patty Gower for joining us. Married at First Sight Australia is next on 3. See you tomorrow night at 7. Good night.